In this video tutorial, we will understand what is automobile cooling system. Different components come under it and working of modern type of automobile cooling system. All you friends, welcome to my video channel. I am Sunil Wadokar, assistant professor in mechanical department, working at Dr. V. Bikol, the College of Engineering, Malkapur. So let's get started with this video. Here, firstly, I will explain engine cooling, then air-cooled engines, then liquid-cooled engines, then after that thermostat and compartment heating. Although engines have improved very lot, but they are still not very efficient. Converting chemical energy into mechanical work or mechanical power. Out of the total energy from the fuel, some of the energy is used to utilize or to perform the work, and remaining energy in the system heats the engine and the temperature in the engine increases. To cool the heated engine and to maintain at proper working condition, we require the cooling system in the engines. Cooling system transfer this excess heat to the surroundings. Water cool engine removes heat at faster rates and prevent the engine by getting damage from this excess heat. Then after that we look marine engines. Marine engines, water is used to cool the engine directly. Then after that, air-cooled engines use large volume of air to cool the engine and a fan to maintain the engine temperature. If the working condition is very cold and engine is operating at very less temperature, then power and efficiency will decreases and components inside the engine will wear faster because of that ice inside the cylinder. If the engine conditions are too hot, then heat will affect very badly on the engine and there might be chances of getting engine damaged. For that, it is very necessary to operate the engine at optimum or normal conditions. Now we will take a closer look at different cooling systems inside the automobile. Firstly, we will take thermo syphon cooling system. This system of cooling is also known as natural circulation method. In thermo syphon cooling system, the property of water is used. As the hot water heats, it expands and becomes lighter and get rises. It has natural tendency to get upwards. This hot coolant then rises up and flows through the radiators from up to down. In radiator, this hot water or hot coolant is cooled by using the fan outside the radiator. Here the temperature of coolant decreases before getting inside the engine again. In this system, no pump is used. Circulation is powered by the convection process alone. A lot of wire required and a poor control of temperature is the disadvantage of thermosiphon cooling system. Then we will discuss another system of cooling. We will take a look at air-cooled engines. In air-cooled engines, large fins are provided on the external surfaces of engine that dissipates the heat into the surrounding. Cooling rate is controlled by varying sizes of fins. Here sometimes a large fan is used to displace the heat to the atmosphere. This system of cooling the engine is simple and lightweight. Coolant does not have to be changed. and there is does not have any damage due to the cooling or at cooling below 0 degree centigrade. Disadvantages of this cooling system are the system is noisy, a large fan is required, and sometimes the engine gets overheated very quickly. Volkswagen Beetle car use this type of engine cooling system, and still this vehicle is very popular. Now we will take a look at modern water cooled engine. Here are some of the different components that utilizes in water cooled engine, that is thermostat, engine block, heater core, water pump, radiator, radiator fan, expansion tank, and cap of radiator tank. In a modern water cooled engine, pump circulate the water through the pipes and through the engine casings, and heat is absorbed inside the coolant of that engine and thus cooling the engine. When the engine is heated and the temperature of the coolant or water is increased very rapidly, then thermostat valve changes its position and allow the water to flow from the radiator. The front in front of radiator get actuated with the help of ECU, electronic control unit. This hot water is then cooled inside the radiator by utilizing the fan and the radiator system. In heat exchanger or radiator, the arrangement is made in such a way that the water is get into different sections where the fins or the different parts of the radiator, the heat absorbed at the metal fins inside the radiator at larger rate, and this heat is dispensed to the atmospheric condition. Now we will learn what is thermostat and how it works. Thermostat is basically a valve which regulates the flow of coolant. When the water is at cold condition, the water bypass way, it does not go to radiator and it does go to the storage tank and again by pump to the engine. But when the water gets heated, the temperature increases, and this increase in temperature causes melting of the wax which is set inside the center part of the thermostat or central arrangement. This opens the thermostat valve, and then after the hot water is directed towards the radiator and which get cooled in the radiator, then after it comes to the pump again for flowing or floating inside the engine. Again, when the water cools, the thermostat valve get close towards radiator. A spring is used in thermostat to perform that action. The radiator pressure cap used to pressurize the system to specific overpressure, which raises the boiling point of the coolant. It also acts as pressure relief valve, preventing damage and other connections. As water heats up, it expands and excess water is allowed to flow to the expansion tank. Later, when the engine cools down, negative pressure in the water system or cooling system sucks the water back through a vacuum valve in a cap. Then after that, we will understand what the compartment heating is. For the interior heating system, coolant flows towards heater core located near the dashboard of the car. An electric fan assists the movement of the air. That air flows on the heater core. Vents direct this air towards windscreen area, also towards the passenger area and towards the floor area as required into the system. in modern systems or modern cooling system, the engine is cooling controlled by engine cooling unit, as thermostat measures the engine temperature. By this information, ECU controls the flow of fluid towards the radiator and also controls the fans near to the radiator. The compartment is also controlled by ECU, that is electronic control unit. And finally, we will understand the behavior of water in our system. We consider that water has a capacity to hold a lot of heat, but on other hand, it has some undesirable properties. It has maximum density at 4 degrees centigrade and expands either the temperature increases or decreases. If water in a cooling system freezes, then it will burst the wiring, it will burst the pipelinings and radiator inside the automobile. When water get heated, it boils at very low temperature, that is 100 degrees centigrade. That boiling water produces steam bubbles, which like insulator in the system. To increase the boiling point of the water, pressure in the system needs to be increased, and to lower the freezing point, it needs some special chemical to be added inside the water. A chemical antifreeze is added. Normally we added ethylene glycol as antifreeze mixture to the water. Ethylene glycol also prevents tanks, the system, the pipes and the major components to be get corroded from the water. In this way, we have completed this tutorial which explains the cooling system in automobile. Thanks to all of you friends for watching this tutorial carefully.